Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we're going to make a Young Buck style track. He was a member of G-Unit, which was, based around the energy of 50 Cent when he was hot around like 2006, I want to say. I'm probably making up that, making that year up. But it was back when I was in like sixth grade. He was super hot when he came up with the song in the club. So anyway, let's get the Young Buck style down. We're going to play a lot of octave supported chords. So what I'm going to do here is start with brass. Let's open up Kontakt. We have session horns preloaded, just the factory preset, the first preset here. And what I'm going to do is play. Now in my head, I heard. Let me switch the tracks for a second. Here we go. So I heard in my head, and I also heard this tone. So what I did was I used our chord codes to work backwards. So I assume this tone was the number 7, because 7 is the common number between major and minor chords. You can learn a lot more, again, for free at BusyWorksBeats.com/music theory. So for example, I can take this tone and build a full chord. And all I did was use our chord codes working backwards. So I assume this was the number 7. All I did was count down the keyboard, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. And I assumed it was a minor chord. So I just continuously counted. So let me show you the keyboard as well so you can see what I'm looking at. Okay, so I assume the next note, since this was a black note, I also assume that the next note was going to be a black note. So this is 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. So I'm going to go with the minor. And then 2, 1, 0. So these are all black keys. And what I'm going to do is use an octave, or I'm going to use this bottom note, D sharp. I'm gonna play it in two lower octaves. So it's the same note in three octaves that adds that bite. Now all I'm doing with the chords is taking this F sharp and pulling it down to F. So that creates the two chord options. That's all I'm doing for the chord. So I'm gonna record those chords to the metronome at 87 BPM. That's a lower BPM. You know, this is more classic hip hop. So let's record notes and automation. And I'm just gonna play that chord. Okay, so let's hit notes and automation. Let's hit space to record. Okay, so I'm just holding the chord every now and then just to add variety. Also, I'm playing each chord at a different velocity, so it's going to trigger a different style of playing in this specific plugin. Now, some notes are early, I can tell, because they're forming before the beat. So let me move these chords over a bit. So I move the whole thing a little to the right, so it's a little more in the groove. I'm going to do the same thing. You can even copy and paste. If you're really lazy, just copy that. We're going to open up a piano in track 4. So here's what it would sound like if we played the same exact thing. But what I'm going to do is extend the piano chords. So we can still copy and paste the MIDI. But for this first chord, I'm going to actually drag it out. I'm going to drag out every other main chord. Let's turn this down so we start to have a balance. Let's go to our playlist. Let's right click. Let's insert pattern 1 and pattern 2. Pattern 1 is the brass. Pattern 2 is the piano. So I don't want the piano outshining the brass. So let's turn that piano down. I'm gonna drag these chords out. So the piano is just for back tone. It's not to be a main element. Let's move into pattern 3. And here we have the, let's go up 2 octaves. We have slurring violins. So you have a lot of articulations in the East-West libraries. You can see how many are just for the violins alone. This is why when you're looking for sample libraries, a lot of them come with only one style of playing that specific instrument. But in real life, you can play, for example, the electric guitar. You can play it, you know, thousands of different ways just on one specific tone. So let's add these little slurs in here. Mainly at the fills and the drops. And I'll figure out a way to arrange it, but let's record it in first. So I'm just going down the scale. These are better takes. The first take wasn't as good, so we're gonna use the second and third takes. So let me try one more fill. I wanna go, but I messed it up at the end. So let's record that into pattern four. So I'm going to use those as the fill, meaning something to go at the end of something. So I'm going to use that towards the end. I think that was where I messed up. So let's add that in. So it just adds like a background energy, just something very subtle. For the piano, I'm going to add one more thing. It's going to go over top of the whole track. We're going to go up two octaves and just, again, going up the scale. Actually, let's go down. I'm going to hold my sustain pedal. Let me show you the MIDI screen. So I'm holding the sustain pedal, which means the tones are going to last longer. Let me give you the full view. Scroll up. So we have two D sharps, and I'm playing F, which is not in a chord. It's in the scale, not in the chord. So I'm just gonna play those notes, but using the sustain pedal. So I might do something like this. Let's try that. So I'm going to record this. It might mute the other piano take, which is fine because we don't need to hear it because it's the same thing. Let's go to notes and automation. So I'll keep it simple. I'm not going to do a thousand of those, but those are just little things you can add for flair and variety. So let's move everything over just a little bit to the right, just to let it fit in the groove a bit. You can see it's a little early. So you can add these, you know, in the verse, just something to spice it up. Now in part two, we're gonna go over the drums and the bass. Let's move into part two where we're going to manipulate the drums. In this section, we're going to go over the drums. So let's go to busyworksbeats.com and let's first get the vibe of the track, and then we're going to get the characteristics we need in the drums. So do we need a full acoustic drum kit? Probably not. Do we need a lot of hi-hat rolls? Probably not. So let's go to busyworksbeats.com. Let's load up the Ultimate Producer Bundle 1. Let's go to the Ultimate, the Hip Hop Edition. Drums, let's pull up a kick. These have more boom bap kicks. I'm gonna use the 50 kick. Let's open that up a new channel. Let's grab a clap. I'm gonna layer that clap with a snare so you can get that hard New York type of sound. Let's open that up. Let's grab a hi-hat. Let's collapse the structure. Now let's go to our channel rack and let's start sending these to the mixer. 5, 6, 7, and 8. Now the hi-hat's gonna be very simple. So it's gonna go boom, tick, clack, tick, boom, tick, clack, tick. So the drums aren't gonna be crazy. It's just gonna be very simple. So the hi-hat is going on the and. 1, 2, 3, 4. So that's where the hi-hats are going. Let's go to pattern 7. The kick's gonna go on the 1. And it's gonna be very linear. Boom, clap, boom. Very simple. So boom, clap, boom, clap. This allows us to add more grooves through instrumentation if you wanted to add more movement like guitars. Let's make the clap a little more delayed. Let's go to our wrench tool. Let's turn up time shift. So it delays that clap a bit. You don't want to delay it too much. Hi-hat, let's delay it just a tiny bit, not a lot. We don't want to make a West Coast swing. Turn down the hi-hat in the mix. Does not need to be loud. And for the kick, I'm going to use the fade-out parameter. Make it a little bit shorter. It has a little too long a tail. For this specific song. Now we just need background support elements like guitar. We could use the synth versions, but I would choose for live guitar, but let's just see what we can do with some synth. I think FL Snare might help us a bit. Let's try FL Snare. Change the mode to solo, dynamic. Turn your speed up a little bit so you can do portamento bends. We're gonna take off the processing, so we're gonna turn it on dry. Sorry if that was clipping your speakers. Let's go to track 9. Let's turn this down. Now, real guitar would sound a little more elegant, obviously. Let's load up Guitar Rig, and I want to run it through some specific effects to get that kind of funk feel. So let's go to Guitar Rig, let's go to Styles, let's go to Funk, and we're going to look for Auto Wah or Auto Filter presets. So for example, Funky Auto Wah, let's load that up. It has an auto filter, which means when I play a key velocity, the velocity controls the amount of the cutoff frequency, the filter cutoff frequency. So that moves based on the velocity. It gives you this kind of wah. And based on your velocity, since I'm playing the same way all the way through, you can change your sensitivity, et cetera, et cetera. You can change your filter type to more of a low pass rather than band pass. Okay, so let's try this out just to see. Trying to think of the best note combo we can do. I want it more of a wah kind of wow wow wow. So we have that in Omnisphere, but let me try these presets. These are just based on velocity. So we might use the Omnisphere version. Let's use Omnisphere instead. They also have some guitars. Now we have Omnisphere open. Let's look for a guitar, and I'm going to run it through different effects. Let's see. Let's go with the bluesy lead. I like this one the most. What I'm going to do is take off the reverb and the delay. So let's go to our effects under A, turn that spring reverb and the delay off. And I think we have a wah pedal in here. So if we go to A, load up the effects, I guess it'd be under filter. Let's go to wah wah. It has an automatic. So I'm going to add those in on the downbeats in the key of the song, so D sharp. So let's add that for that southern type of vibe. The only thing is we need to match our tempo to the wah speed. So we need to go to sync. And I'm going to turn my rate to wow something fast. Let's try 1/4. So now it matches better. Now we could speed up the kick drum rhythm. Boom, ba boom, boom, ba boom, boom. So let's do that just to make it more spicy, because right now it's kind of bland. So notice the kicks are overlapping the snare. So it just adds a little more energy. So if you want more energy, you can add a synth to emphasize that bass and the drop. So let's go to menu, initialize preset, turn the sawtooth to -2 octaves. And let's play a really low bass note just to add more energy. I'm going to also, let me see here, let's add more voices. It's not going to add more energy by adding more voices, but let's detune them. That adds more of a stereo spread, so we get a nice thick sawtooth. So I'm going to go bum, 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 bum with the saw. So we're going to match the kick's energy. Okay, so bum, ba bum, bum, ba bum, bum. So that's the energy. I'm going to drop that down 1 octave, hitting control down. So it just adds a little something, especially with the contrast of these high pianos. So I'm going to add another bar to that piano. Now we need to watch our levels because we're clipping. So let's turn everything down. Now usually I don't move the faders all at once. I'll do the channel volumes. But just for the video, I'm going to, I don't know why, I reset all the notes. Let's just turn everything down. Now stuff needs reverb and delay to kind of be to fill up space. So let's create an aux reverb. I like to use Altiverb. This is an impulse response reverb, which means the sounds are going to run through these environments as if they were recorded in these environments. So let's load up an environment like, let's see here. Let's go to different studios. I just like clicking on random studios every time. So let's try the Whistlelord. Not sure if I'm saying that correctly. I'm just going to click on a random one. So anyway, this is on an aux track, which means I'm sending a dry signal, which are these mixer tracks, to a dedicated effect called an aux track. And I'm going to use this at 100% wet level, which means at 100% effect. So that's a dedicated wet track for effects. Let's go to EQ. We teach you more about that at busyworksbeats.com/mixingacademy. A lot more about aux reverbs and different things. So let's EQ out some of the low end of the reverb so we don't get an extra mud. And I'm going to start sending things through that reverb, like brass. So I'm going to click on the brass track on track two, left click and pull up the amount. So now the brass feels like it's in that environment. Now the thing is, you want to go to your plugins and make sure it doesn't have any reverb already on it. So a lot of this stuff is already processed. So let's just triple check. Let's go to sound, make sure any reverb is off. Let's turn it off. So you see reverb was on before. I'm going to take it off. Let's go through each element. Send the piano through the reverb. Send the strings through the reverb. Every musical element basically is going to go through. Except the synth. I'm gonna run the hi-hats through and a little bit of the snare. Since this room isn't huge, you don't hear much of a reverb tail anyway. Let me pitch the kick down. Now you can add mute guitars if you want. I'm going to use FL Slayer, but I would usually go for a library and Sonic Synth for the muted guitar because it has a nice sample. But let's just do it with FL Slayer to keep it simple for now. I'm going to change the mode to solo dynamic and turn up damp mode. This will give you the muted tone. Let's turn off any effects. We don't want any effects. I want to change your string. Let's go with Sonic Synth actually, but I think it might give me an error when I load up the library because I moved my hard drive. Let's load up Sonic Synth, see if we can get a better muted guitar. There aren't many sample libraries with muted guitar samples, not even in Omnisphere, I don't believe. I could be wrong, but I haven't seen it. So this takes a little bit to load up, but it does have a good muted guitar sound. So let's let this load. And then we're going to layer this with the track to add more rhythm. But since we up the kick drum rhythm, we don't need as much other stuff to move the track along. Okay, so if we were to keep the drums very basic as we had them before, you would need other elements to move the track along to add more energy and keep it upbeat. Okay, so I might have to pause this video. I'm not sure how long this is going to take. Now we're in Sonic Synth 2. Let's load up the guitar. Let's find the electric guitar, not acoustic in this case. And let's scroll down to the ultra mute. Let me turn it up. I can't even hear it. I guess I wasn't hitting the key hard enough. So I'm going to add these in. Oh, you know what? It's on track 11. So let's add this in. So we're gonna go bum bum bum. So that D sharp. So we can go 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's go to piano roll. I'm just gonna show you how to do it quickly in MIDI. It's the same thing if you're playing it. You're just playing it with the same rhythm. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. The difference is we're gonna play them at slightly different velocities. Slide this over. I'm going to duplicate. So I'm going to go up, down, downish, down further, so that the first note is the accented note. Let's add that in. Now it sounds whatever right now, but let's, you know, once we process it and fit it into the mix, it'll have its place. So let's add that into the playlist. Let's turn it down a bit. Let's let it come in a little bit later in the song. You can see it's carrying a lot of the rhythmic weight. And it's not too aggressive as far as tone. Okay to be a little bit early. Usually I would say to delay it a bit using the wrench tool, using time shift, but it actually sounds better as is, which is right on the grid, because it's reminding us what the tempo is. Now we just need a little more bass, so what I might do is thicken up. We don't have any bass, what am I saying? We're gonna add a sub bass. But I'm not gonna use a bass guitar, we're just gonna go with 3X OSC. We're gonna create a sub bass layer, so it just rests underneath the track. It's gonna be very simple, it's gonna be in the rhythm of the kick. All I'm gonna do is copy what we did in the Silent One with the synth, the sawtooth. Let's paste that in the 3X OSC. Let's lower our coarse pitch down to, you know, the bottom, which is 2 octaves lower than where it started. Every octave is 12 semitones, so we're counting every 12. So it goes 24, 12, that's an octave lower. Then 12 less would be 0 in this case, in this specific plugin. So now we have a low octave sub bass, and I'm just going to let that ride through the song. Just a common bass line. We don't have to do anything special. And that's going to make the kick feel like it's doing a little bit more, even though it's not just the kick. It's the kick and the sub. Monitor so we can listen through the headphones. Of course, mixing would take this to a different level. But we need the vocal before we mix to get a better idea of what we can do. Of course, you can add more percussion if you want. Time, and then we're going to record in the mind of the artist in the next half. Move into the next section where we add the freestyle in the mind of the artist. So I'm going to come up with the hook. I came up with like, if you scared, go to church. If you scared, go to church. Because we putting in that work. If you scared, go to church. Something like that. In this last section, we're going to record in the mind of Young Buck to the track. So I'm going to come up with different ideas, maybe hook ideas. Again, it doesn't have to be pure English. You could talk gibberish as long as you're getting the melodic and tone ideas across. You don't have to worry about the exact words. In songwriting, they start with the melodies and the accents before they even get to writing the words, most times. So let's do that technique. I'm just going to record. We're going to do a little freestyle. I'm going to double it so I have room to actually continue on if I need more space. Okay, so let's go back to our mixer. Make sure your microphone is armed to record. To record audio into playlist as an audio clip. You scared, go to church. I'm trying to think of how Young Buck talks.
unit. It's the unit. Young Buck, 56, Tony Yayo. G-Unit. It's Buck. Yeah, if you scared, go to church, my nigga. Run time, probably putting in the work, my nigga. Yeah, cause if you scared, go to church, my nigga. Run time, parent, putting in the work, my nigga. Gotta put in the work in. I can't straight up, they ain't know we was working. And if these girls had the girls all twerking, it was perfect in the whip with circus song. I mean, Percy, cause the whip was smirking. I mean, swerving, whipping white with the curve in. I mean, cursing with the whip with the verses. I mean, damn, I'm just spitting the verses. Verse in the way in the hearse. If they wanna get hurt, put in work, put in work. I be torn with the dead in the streets with the bunk. They was dead in the streets. The 50 told me to pull up a bank, and bank told me to pull up a bank and get paid. And Buck told me to put in the work, and Buck told me to put in the dirt and get sprayed.
See, I caught his flow more towards the end. Let me try that one more time, just in case I come up with a better approach. So it takes a while to get in the mind of the artist sometimes. Let's try that one more time. Yeah.
50 told me go ahead and get paid, yeah. 50 told me go ahead and get paid, yeah. 50 told me go ahead, but get. 50 told me go ahead, but get. 50 told me go ahead and get paid. 50 told me go ahead, but get. Banks told me go ahead, but get. Banks told me go ahead, but get. What you know about me, mouth from the side. Got the diamonds in the whip, diamonds in my mouth. 180 in the yard, we a pull a mat. Just in case they wanna rumble, I buck a mat. Yeah, Buck got a truck in the truck at the pump. Just in case they wanna jump, you a chump. They get jumped if we came up in the crib. You get stuck, you don't want it in your ribs. Buck, yeah, you a Buck 50. G unit, came straight up 50. 100 racks in the banks, transferred. Many wire my account with the transfers. Got furs on furs, furs on furs, furs on furs. 56, this is you. Buck told me go ahead and pay, yeah. Banks told me go ahead and get paid, yeah. 50 told me go ahead and get paid, get at the top, young nigga, get paid, get paid. Yeah. Buck told me go ahead and get paid, yeah. Banks told me go ahead and get paid, yeah. 50 told me go ahead and get paid, young nigga.
So that was a little bit better than the first take. I like the end of the first take. So I'll go through both just to show you how to get in the mind of the artist. I'm trying to catch the resonance of Young Buck. I know how to kind of position my throat, but there was a certain section where it's a throat thing. So anyway, I'll play it both takes through. So also, let me send these tracks from track 100 so you don't hear all that excess reverb. Try this one more time.
Unit. It's the unit. Young Buck. 56. Tony Yayo. G-Unit.
It's Buck.
Yeah. If you scared, go to church, my nigga. Run time, probably putting in the work. Church, my nigga. Right time, period, putting in that work, my nigga. Yeah, cause if you scared, go to church, my nigga. All pop, man, putting in the work, my nigga. Yeah, cause if you scared, go to church. Yeah, cause if you scared, go to church. Young Buck gotta put in the work in. I can't straight up, they ain't know we was working. And niggas, girls had the girls all twerking. It was perfect in the whip with circus song. I mean, Percy, cause the whip was smirking. I mean, swerving, whipping white. I'm just spitting the verses. Verse in the way in the hearse. If they wanna get hurt, put in work, put in work. I be torn with the dead in the streets. With the bronc, get to the bronze, they was dead in the streets. The 50 told me to pull up the bank. 50 told me go ahead, buck it. 50 told me go ahead, get paid. 50 told me go ahead, buck it. Bass told me go ahead, buck it. Bass told me go ahead, buck it. What you know about me, mouth full of sigh. Got the diamonds in the whip, diamonds in my mind. 180 in the yard, we a pull a mat. Just in case they wanna run, but I'll buck a mat. Yeah, buck, got a truck in the trunk, got the pump. Just in case they want jump, you a chump. It get jumped. Yeah, you a buck 50, G unit, came straight up 50. 100 racks in the banks, transfer. Man, they wire my account with the transfers. I got furs on furs, furs on furs, furs on furs. 56, this is you. Buck told me go ahead and pay, yeah. Banks told me go ahead and get paid, yeah. 50 told me go ahead and get paid, get at the top, young.
So you get the gist. You can add on to it or take away from it. But that's the exercise you need to get in the habit of doing, is adding verses and hooks in the mind of the artist so that you can take it from just a beat idea into a full idea so people can understand where you're trying to take your track, and you can collab on different levels or just put it out as you like. But that's how you make a song demo, and that's what I'm trying to show you, how to get, you know, how to understand the full process so you can get from point A to point B. So if you want to learn more about songwriting, you want to go to busyworksbeats.com/musictheory. You can click that link below. It'll guide you through all the principles of pure songwriting, how to get through the musicality of a song, tension and release, how to keep people interested in your song, etc., etc. So thank you for watching today. It's BusyWorks Beats.
Create complete compositions with comprehension. Master music theory. Visit BusyWorksBeats.com/musictheory for your free bonuses and free music theory tutorials. Want to learn how to make beats like the pros? Join now for free at BusyWorksBeats.com and learn the secrets of the pros. Professional mixing secrets finally revealed. Get 3 free videos straight from the new Mixing Academy Complete course package at BusyWorksBeats.com/Mac.